Yes, children. So those who prepare green wars with wars with gas or wars with fire, victory with no survivors, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade doing nothing. So here is a reference to the people, those who wage war, maybe against nature, maybe against the humanity in one way or the other. Right? And the poet says that at the time of introspection, self-introspection, what will happen? That these people who wage wars or the warmongers, they will stop doing those violent activities. They will stop going in for maybe war against nature or maybe war against humanity. The war may be of any kind. Maybe it is a war fought with ammunition or maybe with... maybe it's a nuclear war or maybe it's a bio war, the way it's going on now, right? So whatever the kind of wars are there by the warmongers, at the time of self-introspection, those people will stop doing those violent things and will think about what they have been doing. They will realize that their actions had been very, very wasteful. Why wasteful? Because at this time of introspection, they will realize that they were waging war for victory when no one will be surviving to enjoy with them. So if they are waging war, the purpose is, of course, to win. But what is the purpose of victory when there is no one else to celebrate with you? So those people will realize the futility of waging war. Because in the end, no one will be left to celebrate victory with them. Right? If you wage war against one country, then how can you say that that country will not do the same thing with you? If you destroy one country, then some other country can destroy you. So this is a chain. So eventually, if you go for war, then eventually no one will be left to celebrate in the end. Then what's the use of that kind of war? So the poet says that those people who wage war, they will put on clean clothes. Putting on clean clothes is a metaphorical expression, which means changing their mindset. Okay, putting on clean clothes means changing mindset. So those people who had been warmongers, they will change their mindset and they will realize the importance of unity, brotherhood and peace. And they will walk about with their brothers in the shade, doing nothing. So then those people will realize the importance of peace and brotherhood. And they will walk about with their brothers. They will be united with the whole world and will do nothing that would harm the world or the nature. What I want should not be confused with total inactivity. Now the poet makes one thing more clear. He says that, yes, I have been asking about stillness and silence, but please don't confuse my idea of quietude with death. Don't say that I am advocating total inactivity. Total inactivity is when you stop doing anything, when you stop saying anything, and when you stop thinking anything. But here in his case of, in his concept of quietude, there is stillness and silence, but plus there is thinking. Thinking keeps us alive. So he says, don't confuse my idea of quietude with death. Life is what it is about. So life is all about moving ahead. Life is not about stopping. What is the purpose of life? The purpose of life is going ahead, moving ahead. It is never ever stopping. But what is the poet doing? The poet is asking us to stop for some time and become silent and then think and then move on. Life is not about stopping, but the poet is asking us to stop. But he's asking us to take a break only for some time, not forever. Okay, life is all about moving ahead, not stopping. But if the poet is asking us to stop, that is only for a few seconds. And the purpose of stopping for a few seconds is to think or to evaluate our actions or to assess our doings so that we are able to redo the things in a positive manner. So I want no truck with death. Truck means over here association. The poet says that I don't want any association of my quietude with death. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt the sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with the death. So he says that if we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving. So he says that basically what we want? We want to move ahead. The sole purpose of our life is to move ahead. Had it not been so, then yes, we might have killed ourselves with thoughtless actions. What is the purpose of life? To move ahead. If we are not determined to move ahead, then we might end up doing things endlessly, thoughtlessly. Got it? So he says that if we have not been able to understand ourselves, we are not able to understand ourselves, we don't understand ourselves when we do something without thinking. And the best way to go ahead is to move ahead is stop for a time, stop for a while, think, and then redo what is required. Otherwise, we will be doing disaster to our life if we don't take a break. Because thoughtless actions are always disastrous. Actions without thoughts are always disastrous. So what is required? Take a break, think, analyze, then start. Okay? So perhaps the earth can teach us as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. So the poet says that I am advocating the concept of quietude, which means that become quiet, become still, think, and then redo. So point is that he's asking us to take a break. And he says that even earth can teach us that there is a better life after break. What happens to the earth in the winter season? In the winter season, the earth seems to be sleeping with the white snow as a sheet upon it. And after the winter is over, spring comes. And you know what spring is? When the earth seems to be whole alive with all colors and vibrance. In winter, the earth seems dead. But when spring comes, then the earth seems to be alive with all, you know, enthusiasm, zest, vibrance, colorfulness. So similarly, if we will take a little break from our actions and we analyze like whether we have been doing something right or wrong, then we restart with all rejuvenation and zest. Then the outcome, then our actions, then our, you know, work will be 100 times better than it was earlier. So earth can also teach us. Okay. So perhaps the earth can teach us as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. So how can earth teach us that there is a life afterwards? Through the example of winter and spring. Now I'll count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I'll go. And he says, now I have taught you how can you make your life better. How can you add meaning to your life? And it is through becoming quiet and still for some time and introspecting your actions. This way, when you will do, then your life will become far better. So she says, now I'll count up to 12 and you all keep quiet and I'll go. So during this time of, you know, counting up to 12, you start meditating, you start introspecting. So when you do this, then I have done my job. Then my mission is over and you do quietitude and you realize your aim in life. Right? So what's the significance of the number 12? Number 12 is very significant as far as numerology is concerned. 12 number means 12 months in a year, and 12 also means 12 hours in a clock. Okay, 12 hands in a clock. So without 12, time doesn't, you know, time is doesn't show itself as accurately as it is. Okay, then there are some questions. Let us discuss them. What will counting up to 12 and keeping still help us achieve? So what will counting up to 12 and keeping still help us achieve? It will help us achieve the benefits of self-introspection. It will help us achieve the benefit of self-analysis. That is, we'll be able to take a break from the mundane and dull life or routine. And that break will help us see or understand the wrong we have been doing. And then when we would restart the work, we would be doing it far better than it had been done earlier. So that will also help us achieve peace of mind. That will also help us achieve harmony. Okay, peace, harmony, and happiness. So do you think the poet advocates total activity and death? What's the answer? Is the poet advocating total inactivity and death? Yes, yes, yes or no? Is the poet advocating total inactivity or death? No, the poet is not advocating total inactivity or death, because he is asking us to become quiet only for some time so that we restart the work with all rejuvenation and zest. So he doesn't want the concept of quietude to be associated with death. Okay? Death means that when you cannot redo again. Death is the end of all. But the poet's idea of introspection is redoing the things with all enthusiasm. His concept of quietude is only about taking a break. And the purpose of taking break is to analyze as to what we have been doing or what we should do. What is the sadness that the poet refers to in the poem? What is the sadness that the poet was talking about in the poem? Yes, children? Refer to the lines. Refer to these lines. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with the death. So what is that sadness which the poet is talking about? What is that sadness? What is that sadness? Who will give answer? You can send the answer in your chat box also. What's the sadness? The sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. And of threatening ourselves with death. These are the two things which is the answer for this. So the point is that human beings don't understand themselves. Why don't they understand themselves? Because they keep on doing something recklessly, thoughtlessly. They don't realize, like, why are they doing that? What is the purpose of that action? So when human beings don't do anything thoughtfully, that is being sad. Yes, Vanshika, of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. Yes. So sadness is about not understanding ourselves. And it is about threatening ourselves with death. Can you explain, like, how do we threaten ourselves with death? if we talk about the poem, then the poet says that man gathering salt. So if the man was gathering salt for his survival, then isn't he killing himself? If the people are waging war against other countries, aren't they threatening themselves also with the death? So when we try to do wrong to others, then in a way we are threatening ourselves equally. Okay, now the next question is, what symbol from nature does a poet invoke to say that there can be life under apparent stillness? So what symbol from nature does the poet take? He takes a symbol of earth. He invokes the earth to teach us that there is a life after stillness. When winter comes, can spring be far behind? So when winter comes, spring will definitely be there. So if you'll be quiet and still for some time, then you'll be able to make your life better than what it was earlier. Provided you come up with your introspection, right? Okay, so that's it. The poem has finished. So yesterday there was MCQ test, and because of the way I had already told you everything about the poem, majority of you was able to do well in the test. Am I right? So even then, if there is some doubt, you can ask me in the next class, and we would be picking up the next chapter. So after this, we'll be picking up the third level. Okay.